Hello, welcome once again. In this case, we are going to continue with the defects due to the yarn, but in this case, we are going to talk about irregular yarns. What are we going to explain about irregular yarns? Well, here we can say that the description is due to a variation in the thickness of a yarn. Okay, so usually what we are going to find is an irregular shape, or we are going to find that the thickness is not homogeneous, and obviously is not homogeneous when it was supposed to be homogeneous, okay? Because sometimes, because of fashion, because of trends, we want to design irregular yarns, okay? And in this case, it won't be a defect. About the appearance of this defect, we can say that it's mainly observed as a change in the color, but basically because we change the thickness, there are lack of some threads, different hairiness, okay? So it's a difference in the structure, okay? Sometimes we can observe a difference in the color, mainly due to the fact that we can observe neighborhood yarns, and then it makes a difference in the shade of the fabric. The main cause is in the spinning process, and is due because of the breakage on the spinning process, for example, of some thread, or because we miss part of the fibers, right? So let's move to see how we can observe this defect in the yarn. Okay, here in the image, we can clearly observe that this part, for example, is fatter than this other part, okay, that is thinner. So when we join those yarns in the fabric, we would observe that the compactness is higher in the region where we have the fatter parts, and it's not as compact when we have the thinner parts, right? So this is going to create a defect and an irregularity in the fabric, which would be a lack of quality in the product. Okay, thank you very much for your attention, and I wait for you in the next video.